Hello guys, I hope that you are doing well in this unprecedented time of COVID-19. Further, today's lecture is very important because all the designing in next lectures depends on today's lecture. And I hope you guys will focus on this lecture. Okay, so far we have studied combinational circuits wherein output at any instant of time entirely depends on inputs. Also, in practice, most of the digital circuits are comprised of combinational circuits and memory element. These circuits are termed as sequential circuits. So in the sequential circuit, we need a combinational circuit as well as some memory element. So these types of circuits are known as sequential circuits. Next, in few lecture, we will focus on the sequential circuits. Okay, and furthermore, we divide the sequential circuits into two types. One is known as synchronous sequential circuits, and other is known as asynchronous sequential circuit. In the synchronous sequential circuits, its behavior depend on the knowledge of its signal at discrete instant of time. I'm going to repeat, in the synchronous sequential circuits, the behavior of this circuit depend on the knowledge of its signal at discrete instant of time. Now, what are these discrete instant of time? In this lecture, later on we will discuss in detail, but now I am telling you the discrete instant of time are the clock pulses. These circuits, are these memory elements, are these sequential circuits, are depending upon the clock pulses. When the clock pulses, these usually depend on the clock pulse. Positive edge trigger or the negative edge trigger, when the clock pulse has the positive edge trigger or the negative edge trigger, then its work, it gave the output. So the output depend upon the input as well as these clock pulses. Later on in detail we will see what are these clock pulses. Next, the asynchronous sequential circuits. These are the sequential circuits whose behavior depend on the order in which its input signal changes and can be affected at any instant of time. So in the asynchronous circuits, the output or its behavior depend on the input. Entirely it's depend on the input. When the input changes, its output will change instantaneously. And the synchronous sequential circuit depend on the clock pulses. Okay, next, these sequential circuits, I already told you about these are comprised of combinational circuits and the memory element. So these memory elements are composed of flip-flops, and we will see in this lecture later on, we will see in this lecture what are the flip-flops. Flip-flop, in fact, these are the memory elements. These are used to store the binary information, and one flip-flop is capable of storing one binary bit at a time. Now, okay, let us talk about the sequential circuit. This block diagram or the schematic shows the schematic of the sequential circuit. So now this is the input, and this is the combinational circuit, and this is the memory element. Now the memory element depend upon the combinational circuit, the output of the combinational circuit, and it is used as a feedback, and its output is the feedback to the combinational circuit. So the output depend upon the present state, the next output depend on the present output, as well as the input of the of this sequential circuit. Okay, now let us talk about synchronous and asynchronous sequential circuit. I have already explained about the synchronous and asynchronous sequential circuit. I told you guys that synchronous sequential circuit, those whose behavior or the output depend upon the knowledge of its input signal as well as the discrete time instant or the clock pulses which are given to the memory element of the sequential circuit. Okay, it depend upon the input as well as the clock pulses. These are positive edge trigger or the negative edge trigger clock pulses. Later on we will discuss these synchronous, these clock pulses in detail. And asynchronous sequential circuit, again these are comprised of combinational circuit and the memory element, but their behavior or their output depend on the input, entirely depend on the input. As the input changes, the output will change. Now let us talk about flip-flop or latches. Now first let us talk about RS flip-flop. Let me draw its logic diagram. RS flip-flop is usually comprised of NOR or NAND gate. Okay, I am constructing its logic diagram with NOR gates. This is the NOR gate. So one flip flop is comprised of two NOR gate and these are cross coupled. It's the output of first gate is the input of second gate and the output of, let me choose some different color. So this is the red color. Is the input of first gate and it has two inputs. This is the reset input and this is the set input. R is for reset and S is for set. Okay, this is the input. Suppose these are the level which I already told you, when voltages are high, this is for 1, this is for 0 and outputs are, so the flip-flop has two inputs and two outputs and the outputs are complement to each other. Sorry, this is the second output, is the complement of first output. Okay, now let me draw its truth table. S is for set and R is reset input and it has two output, Q and Q prime. Okay, let us start that first we are giving set is active high and reset is active low. Let us start with the set button. So when the set is high, you guys know that the NOR gate The output would be 0 when any of input is 1. Okay, it is the complement of OR gate. NOR gate is the complement of OR gate. When any of input is active high or any of input is 1, the output would be 0. So in first case, when S is equal to 1, it is quite obvious that the Q prime is 0. So the Q prime is 0, so it is given to the Q prime is now the input of the first gate and R is already 0. So in this case, the Q would be equal to 1. So the Q would be equal to 1. So this output is equal to 1 and this output is 0. Now another situation, let us put this set button is equal to 0 and reset is equal to 0. Now see what will happen. When reset and the set both are equal to 0, in this case you can see when set is equal to 0, this output Q1 was already, it was equal to 1, so the Q prime will again 0. 1, 0, the output would be equal to 0. And here, this output was already equal to 0 and reset is already equal to 0, so the Q would be equal to 1. Now, next, now we are going to reset this flip-flop when R is equal to 1, keeping R is equal to, this input is equal to 1 and the set is equal to 0. When this is equal to 1, it is obvious that the output Q would be equal to 0. By keeping reset, the output would be equal to, Q would be equal to 0, and when this is equal to 0, this set is also equal to 0, so the output Q prime would be equal to 1. Now in next case, by keeping set and reset is equal to 0, the output will not change. Q will be equal to 0 and Q prime would be equal to 1. So now if I give the output, both set and reset, when both set and reset are equal to 1, in this case both output would be equal to 0, and we never used set and reset equal to 1 simultaneously. Now this is also called, this is the basic flip-flop. This is the basic flip-flop, RS flip-flop. Now, in fact, this is not a flip-flop, this is a latch. And the latch has no clock pulse. So, I am going to modify. In book, you can see, this RS flip-flop can be designed by using NOR gates. Now I am going to the clock RS flip-flop, because this is the latch. When we incorporate some clock pulse, then it is called flip-flop. Now clocked RS flip-flop I am going to describe. Now in this case, I will use two AND gates. This is the AND gate. This is the AND gate. And these have the common clock pulse. So this is the reset. Here this is the reset. input and this is the set input and this is the clock pulse. Now the clock pulse, you know, this is always like this. I mean, pulse 0 and 1, 0 and 1. So these are the voltages. When this clock pulse would be 0, this reset and set both would be equal to 0 and there would be no change as already we know that. So let me draw its truth table. So in fact you have to focus on this circuit. Let me draw its truth table. It has first present state, which is a Q. I mean, now in the entire discussion, I will focus on this output, which has present state Q of T. Now we have set pin, reset pin, and this is the present and then the next state is T plus 1. Okay, now initially suppose this output is equal to 0, this is the present state and the set is equal to 0 and reset is equal to 0. When the set and reset both are equal to 0, when the clock pulse will be active high, this would be equal to 0, this input would be equal to 0. So this is already equal to 0, so this Q prime would be equal to 1. So this 1 would be the input of this first NOR gate, so the output Q will not change, it would be. So this was the present state, this is the next state. When the present state is equal to 0, the next state is equal to 0. Now next the situation is we are going to reset. R is equal to 1, set is equal to 0 and Q, this output is the present state. Now suppose again the present state is equal to 0. Now in this case, now in this case when reset is equal to 1, when the clock pulse will arrive, so this input would be equal to 1 and this would be 0. As this is equal to 1, so the when reset is equal to 1, this input is equal to 1 and this one was already equal to 1, so the output Q would be equal to, the next state would be equal to 0. Now again in next case set is equal to 0 and set is equal to 1 and reset is equal to 0 and the present state we are considering that this is equal to 0. Now in this case what will happen? Reset is equal to 0 and set is equal to 0. When set is equal to 0, this output would be equal to 0 Q prime. So this input would be equal to 0 and reset, this input is equal to 0. So the output would be equal to 1. And again when both set and reset are equal to 1, this is the indeterminate form and we never use this indeterminate form. Indeterminate form and we why to use this form. Okay, next combination is 100. In this case, both set and reset are equal to 0 when reset is equal to 0 and set is equal to 0. So what will happen? The input this one was already equal to 0. So this output was already equal to 1, so this one was 0. So the again when set and reset are equal to 0, so the output, the next state would be equal to 1, because this one was equal to 1, this is complement, this would be equal to 0, 0 and 0 again, it would be equal to 1. So the next combination is 101. So in this case, reset is equal to 1, so when this input is equal to 1, so the output would be, the next state would be equal to 0. And again, next combination is 110. So when set is equal to 1, this output would be equal to 0. And reset is equal to 0, so inputs of this NOR gate are 0 0, so the output would be equal to 1. Now this, when set and reset both are equal to 0, sorry, equal to 1, this is indeterminate form and we never use it, indeterminate form. Okay, next, by using K-map, we can simplify it. Its characteristic equation is, the next state we can determine if we know the present state. And the value of set and reset. So S plus R prime Q. So if you know the present state, the value of reset and the set, you can find out the next state. So as I already told you, the sequential circuits, these depend upon the present state and the inputs. So we can determine the next state by knowing the present state and the inputs of the circuits. So this is the basic RS flip-flop, and graphically we can represent or its block diagram. Let me erase this truth table. So its graphical representation is, this is the clock pulse. If there is no clock pulse, then it is known as latch. So this is the flip-flop when there is a clock pulse, and also it has reset input, which is R, and it has set input, which is S. It has two output, which is Q and Q prime. So if we know the present state, which is the output sum, could be 0 or 1, and if we know the value of set and reset, we can determine the next state. Okay, this is the RS flip-flop. Now let us talk about the D flip-flop. Okay, now Now let us talk about D flip flop. Now in D flip flop, it's quite simple. Now I'm not going to its circuit detail. I will take its graphical representation or the block diagram. So it can be represented. It has always one input, which is D. So D is its input. That's why we call it D flip flop. And this is the clock pulse. And it has two output, those are Q and Q prime. Those are Q and Q prime. Now its truth table, it has D input, sorry, okay, it has in the present state, which is Q, and it has input. So its next state always depend upon the input. So the present state is suppose 0 first, and the input is equal to 0, the next state is equal to 0. If the present state is equal to 0 and the input is equal to 1, the next state would be equal to 1. And present state is equal to 1, input is equal to 0, the next state would be equal to 0. Present state is equal to 1 and input is equal to 1, the next state is equal to 1. Now by solving this truth table, it's by incorporating it into K-map, we will get its characteristics equation. So the characteristic next state entirely depend on the input. So if input is equal to 0, the next state would be equal to 0. Input is equal to 1, the next state is equal to 1. So this is the D flip flop. So we will later on we will use these flip flops in the designing of sequential circuits. Now next, let us talk about JK flip flop. Now the JK flip flop has two inputs. I'm not going to its circuit detail. So this is the graphical representation. It has a clock pulse, two inputs, those are J and K. This is the clock pulse, this is the output, which is Q and Q prime. So its truth table is present state, J is input, K is input, and the output is the next state, and this is the next state. So when input present state is equal to 0, J is equal to 0 and K is equal to 0, the next state would be equal to 0. When the present state is equal to 0, J is equal to 0, K is equal to 1, the next state would be equal to 0. When present state is equal to 0, J is equal to 1, K is equal to 0, Now the next state will change from 0 to 1. Okay. When present state is equal to 0, J is equal to 1 and K is equal to 1, the next state will toggle from 0 to 1. When present state is equal to 1, J and K are equal to both equal to 0, the next state is equal to 1. When the present state is equal to 1, J is equal to 0, K is equal to 1, next state would be equal to 0. When J and present state is equal to 1, J is equal to 1, K is equal to 0, the next state is equal to 1. When both J and K are equal to 0 and present state is equal to 1, it would next state would be equal to 0. Now keep in mind, these tables are very important, these characteristics table. So here we can see that when J and K both are equal to 1, if the present state is equal to 0, it will change to 1. If present state is equal to 1 and JK are equal to 1, then the next state would be 0. Mean it will change from 0 to 1 and 1 to 0 when both J and K are equal to 1. Otherwise, when J is equal to 1, if the present state is equal to 0, it will change into, the next state would be equal to 1. And if present state is equal to 1 and J is equal to 1 and K is equal to 0, the next state remain 1. Now focus on K. When K is equal to 1 and J is equal to 0, if present state is equal to 0, it will remain 0. If present state is equal to 1, it will change into 0. Here you can see this is the characteristic table, so you can solve this truth table. So the characteristic equation is, in this case, the characteristic equation, from characteristic equation you can derive the next state. If you know the present state, this is J to Q complement plus K complement into Q. So if you know the present state here, suppose I'm in table, I'm using this state, when Q is equal to 1, J is equal to 1 and K is equal to 0. Here K is equal to 0 and Q is equal to 1, so it would be equal to 1. This Q prime would be equal to 0, J is equal to 1, it would be 0. So the output would be equal to, the next state would be equal to 1. So this is the JK flip-flop. Now let us talk about T flip-flop, which is also known as the trigger flip-flop. So the T flip-flop, it has only one input, which is T, and it has a clock pulse. This is the T is the input. This is the clock pulse. This is the output. So it's characteristic table. This is the present state, this is the input, this is the next state. When the present state is equal to 0, T is equal to 0, the next state is equal to 0. So when present state is equal to 0 and T is equal to 1, it will change to 1, from 0 to 1. When present state is equal to 1, input is equal to 0, it will remain as 1. When present state is equal to 1, T is equal to 1, it is equal to 0. So it is called toggle, T for toggle. fully flock. So it changed the state. I mean, when it is equal to 1, if the present state is equal to 0, it will change it to 1. If the present state is equal to 1, it will change to 0. Now its characteristic equation you can derive from this characteristic table, which is equal to next state is equal to t into q complement plus t complement, sorry, t prime into q. This is the characteristic equation. From here you can easily derive. That's it. Okay, next we will see again, I mean further we will see the designing of counter by using these characteristics table and the characteristic equation of these flip-flop. And thank you so much.